How you guys doing? John, Indoor Hydroponics. Welcome back. In the spring, in the woods here in Michigan, people go looking for asparagus that grows wild in the woods. I don't do that, but I do have a partially shaded spot in my backyard that I would like to fill in. It just sits vacant. So I thought I'd try putting a row of asparagus in. And I've got them soaking here. There's nine plants, crowns, with their roots. I've got it soaking in this Bigfoot inoculant. And it's got mycorrhiza, biochar, kelp, worm castings, humic acid, all the good stuff in there. But what I'm really looking for is this mycorrhiza. I want those roots to soak that up for a couple of hours just to get them going. And I want that mycorrhiza to bond to those roots, because there is that symbiotic relationship between the mycorrhiza fungi and plant roots. And if we can marry those things up, the plants will take up more water and nutrient and be overall healthy, and it's a good thing. I've got a trench about 1 foot deep, 1 foot wide, and I'm going to mix up a nice little soil mixture in my giant wheelbarrow. I'm going to go three parts good quality compost and manure, one part potting soil. In this instance, Ocean Forest. Ocean Forest has a lot of inoculants in it as well. Got that good and mixed up. And what we're doing here is we're going to start sandwiching the soil and soil amendments in a specific order down the line, and then plant these things out. So very first thing we're going to start off with, we're going to get about a 2-inch layer of that soil mixture down. We're going to pull out our asparagus roots and get them going. Two real important soil amendments, bone meal and worm castings. More on those later. And then I spread out my asparagus roots. I tried to get between 12 and 18 inches between them. They do get rather large over time. So with that being said, we want to plant these things out as though they look like little octopuses, pusses. We spread those roots out, have the crown pointing up. I kind of stabilize them with some of the existing soil, which is pretty heavy. It's beach sand for the most part. And then we're going to top those off with 2 inches of our potting mix, which is the compost in the Ocean Forest. And here's where we start putting the amendments to it. And it looks excessive, but hear me out. We'll get to why. Bone meal, and then we top it off with those earthworm castings, okay? Now we're going to add another 1-inch layer of our soil from the wheelbarrow. Wait for it. Yes, we're going to add another layer of bone meal and earthworm castings, and then we're going to top it with about 1 more inch of that soil. That gives us about 3 to 4 inches over top of the crowns, which is just perfect. Why am I using these amendments? Good question. So I'm trying to create some biology within the soil here, and in order for that bone meal to break down, it needs biology to break it down for us. Soil microbes, bacteria, fungi, things of that nature. And bone meal takes a long time to break down, but it's really good for the plant. Like I say, the first couple of years of asparagus is about creating that root structure. So you want something that's going to feed them over a long period of time to build up that root structure. The worm castings are going to bring the biology into the soil, the microbes, the bacteria, and things of that nature. So there is a relationship between the two. Without the microbes, the bone meal won't break down. So I'm doing the bone meal and the earthworm castings on purpose so that over the long haul, it will break down that bone meal, feed these roots, send up some shoots, and eventually I'll have some asparagus. Now, why am I planting them in partial shade to kind of close this thing out? Because when people walk the woods and find this wild asparagus, which is kind of plentiful up here, it's all in partial shade. It's all in the woods. It grows in partial shade. I get that all the instructions for asparagus is to grow it in full sun. I think if you're trying to just get maximum production, yes, full sun will be good. However, I'm just using it to fill in some space, grow some ferns out the first year, and see if I can't get a few stalks on year 3 and 4. So next up, we wait for them to sprout, and then we're going to hill these things up like potatoes, and we're going to keep building this lasagna of awesome in my backyard. So as always, guys, this is part one. Part two should be out sometime early summer as they start to send up some shoots. Thank you, guys. Love you. Please like, subscribe, and comment, and we will continue indoor hydroponics experiment with asparagus. Thanks. Bye.